Hello, Tony Bear, Venice, California, 3:30 a.m., LAPD, LA Sanitation, encampment, homeless encampment enforcement. There was a break-in at Snapchat. They're not there anymore, but they still have the building. They still own the building. Lots of mentally ill running around Venice. You get rid of the homeless, but you still have that problem with the mentally ill. They need something for the mentally ill, some kind of place for them to go and get help, because they're running loose in Venice. There's one guy in the video with the red underwear on. He was breaking some windows at the old Snapchat building, which they still own. The security called the police. Police showed up, says the building couldn't find the guy. So mentally ill is a big problem here in Venice that has to be solved. So not a lot of encampment, but they have another week to go before they clear it all out. Here's the video. Okay, good evening, everybody. Tony Rare. So you move the homeless off the boardwalk, and guess what? They move into the streets. You know, that's just the way it is. Okay, we're getting a good story right now. Gary Featherstone, a well-known family here in Venice. They had a barbecue place on Albert Kenny for many years, and they were bought out by some rich people. And Gary Featherstone is one of the sons that wound up homeless, in charge of, I think it's called Homeless Enterprises. And he's an advocate for the homeless. Now the sheriff's on his butt. Interesting story. I'll put that in the description if you don't know about it. Okay, there's St. Joseph's Center.
Do you have a lighter, sir? Oh, he's still busy right now. They're always busy, sir. Do you have a lighter or a cigarette? He's walking now, dude. He's always busy, dude, walking. He doesn't have a lighter or a cigarette? A lighter? You don't have a lighter, sir? Use the photo one, dude.
My philosophy is the mentally ill out here, and there's no place for them at all. They put all, it's just like a sad state that it's out here. This is the last section that's left. This is for next week. A lot of tents out in the sand. But it's, it appears to be clear most of the area. All right, there's St. Joseph Center right there in the green. They are hired by the city.
to find homeless people's shelter. Outreach program.
All right, guys. Because I got that through the guy in red underwear that threw that something metal on the ground. Apparently, he broke into a abandoned building. I'm not sure he's in there, but the someone called in and said that someone broke into the building. But you see him on the video, he didn't go in the building. I guess Snapchat still owns that building. Okay, that was the guy earlier drone stuff. Remember the guy with the red underwear on? They think he's still in the building, but he's not. That's what I'm running out. So I guess this is owned by Snapchat. They still think he's in there, but the guy with the red underwear and drone and stuff, he ran up those steps and went behind those bushes, but I believe he came out again. So if there's another week, by the 30th, all this will be cleared. They did it in sections, but I will be doing follow-ups. I guess that's security for Snapchat. Even though they moved to Santa Monica, they still own this property here. It's actually raining out here right now. So this is the last of the big encampment right here. And they have until the 30th to clear. So the good news is German and Venice is gonna do a story on me. That's a good thing. So the guy's not in there anymore, but I guess the cops have to respond. This is LAPD Pacific Division. I've been recording these guys for over 23 years, if not longer. Snapchat security. They're not here anymore, Snapchat, but I guess they still own a lot of properties.
officers, I can't really.
I'm getting it confiscated.
Okay, it came as a code 4, meaning suspect going on arrival. He ran out of the building. There was a guy with the red shorts, the nude guy early in the video.
Thank you.
Okay, these look like some tourists that guess they were out getting to swim just late an hour. Very dangerous out there. There's no lifeguards out there. And then, I mean, it's always good with numbers, but you shouldn't be going out to the sea when there's no lifeguards out there. Just ask for problems. Okay, so we're still waiting for the cleanup. This is the last section over here, and it's scheduled for the 30th, the last of it. So what I'm gonna do is pray for these people. That's all we can do at this point. So apparently the guy with the red underwear broke a lot of windows up in that Snapchat building. They actually moved to Santa Monica. That's been empty for a long time. So apparently he broke some windows in there. This is the last section over this way. It is scheduled for the 30th. It's actually raining out here right now.
That big man over there, he's trying to proposition me wanting to give him a blowjob. Like, I couldn't stay, I'd like for him to stay away from me. I'm in fear of my life. I'm leaving the area. I've never come back to California again. I don't have all. I never will. I can have a fucking castle. I can have that house there. I'll never have a house.
That's a rain. rained a long time here. It's drizzling kind of hard right now, and it's a little chilly. It's starting to come down harder now, the rain. Feels kind of good, because in New York, I used to walk in the rain from 96 to the village in Washington Square Park. What a lovely walk. There's the rain, you can see it. It's coming down harder now. So I won't be able to see the owl. Right now I am developing the hat and t-shirt. It's gonna take some time. I gotta figure out how much they cost, how much it costs to mail them. So it's a long process, but I'm gonna keep Tony Vera in small letters next to the owl, but it will be called the Venice Owl. But Tony Vera is important because that name's all in the search engine. One of my subscribers pointed it out to me. So Tony Vera, the Venice Owl, but Vera will be in small print. So that's the name of that tune. You can actually see the rain now. It's coming down a lot harder than it was a half hour ago.
Shut the fuck up, Bonnie. Nobody wants to hear your bullshit. I fucking care about you.
No, you don't.
Okay, fuck off. Good.
this is a pretty fast sweep. They didn't really stop and mess with any tents. I guess they're gonna wait until the 30th and clear it all out. But there's a lot of mentally ill out here that can't go into housing. So that's one problem they're gonna have to resolve, because the mentally ill have nowhere to go. They're just out here, you know. Maybe not taking the medication. Not a good thing. You gotta do more with mentally ill men. Anyone can be mentally ill. Just take that one bad thing to happen. With me, it was 9/11. Though 9/11, I had a breakdown. Actually, I had to take Prozac. I had to see a psychiatrist. I actually made love on top of the World Trade Building. A friend of mine, Philippe Petit, he actually walked the World Trade Building on a tightrope. So the Trade Center was an amazing building, and we lost a lot of good people in 9/11. So mental illness can happen to anybody. All right, so we're going to be covering the Gary Featherstone saga with the sheriffs. That's an ongoing story. So this is a wrap. It was quick. That's the name of that game. Moving out, people. Stay positive, believe in yourself. Okay. So I slept all day on Sunday. I was cutting a lot of videos. I guess with the Gary Featherstone videos, cutting those. Had a good lunch, fell asleep, woke up, and I actually thought it was Monday morning because it was still light out, and I got a good sleep. But it was actually Sunday night at 7:30, so I actually thought I missed being here tonight. All right, so I'm going back to LAX after the 30th, but I will still be working Venice as the Venice Owl. I'm not going to stop doing Venice. Still going to work it hard. I'll be working the LAX, and I'll be working Venice. So this is a wrap. It's about close to 5 a.m. Starting to rain hard again. And that's about it, people. You know, all we can do is stay positive, say our prayers, and that's about it. I think all my jealousy and my insecurity is on me. You know, I think because I was doing this way back then, I have this jealousy about me that I'm trying to work out. And hopefully I will. Hopefully things will be, for me, normal again. Okay, folks. I'm going to sign off here and send off this video and get some sleep. Get up tomorrow. I got some stuff to do with the lawyers. Won my civil rights lawsuit against Santa Monica police. Civil rights lawsuits, violations to the max. All right, Tony Vera. Signing out.